without you.
Well,
you
thank
need to
you.
Know that at this point. You know that at this point, right?
Yes, I do.
We're
but
like
I
hand
enjoyed
in glove,
it.
Like hand in glove. Like
hand
up and down
yes.
and left and right and all that good stuff. We go together.
Yes, we do.
Yes, we do. You so, enjoyed it?
Oh, yes.
What and was I, your favorite part?
Of course, the health and wellness. How people are just really getting up. They
and
can't
they're
wait.
And they're moving.
They're moving.
Together.
Together.
That's the powerful part for mm-hmm. me. We got our community moving and moving together mm-hmm. for their wellness.
That's it.
Girl, we can't be no colder.
I know.
Give it up for us.
That's it. And this is what I always been saying. Look, Kwanzaa is the perfect place to add health and wellness.
Yes, it is. It's
because
perfect.
Without your health, you can't do all the seven principles
do
and do what you need to be doing,
do
right?
Right, right, right.
So
right.
we're on the right step.
We're on the right path. Step.
Yes,
we're
yes.
stepping,
but
we're
look,
moving on down the right path.
We're moving down the right, right path. Path. But you know, I just love the healing of the arts. And honey, you got us being healed up in here with all this art stuff going on.
My performances the past couple nights. What you think about the past couple nights and the performances?
Oh, my goodness. And tonight,
yeah, tonight
the Paragon Project. Shut your mouth.
But Kali B too.
Kali B, hey.
Hey.
Yes.
And, then
and
last
these are
night,
homegrown folks.
Last
Columbus.
Night we had Brother Me Too.
Yes.
Bless us. And then we had the Marion Franklin Steppers. We had the elders.
Oh, yes.
We got it from the young to the old up in here.
Yeah, the elders, they were doing their thing.
They
weren't
them is about the smoothest elders.
They are smooth, aren't they?
In Columbus, Ohio. I just need you to know. And they fine. They dress. They come dressed.
They right.
To impress.
To impress.
But they red. They splash a red just to let you know they hot.
Yes. Yes. Definitely. Right? Definitely. And
yeah.
so, but, you know, yes. The tradition is
yes.
included.
Yes.
Because that's the foundation of
yes.
Kwanzaa.
Yes.
But now you're opening up the doors for us to bring in the community in real time, yes. so to speak, of what we're doing. Oh, we uh-huh. have a little Missy up in the mix, right?
Right. What's your name?
So what's
girl?
Your name?
I'm Gisana.
Oh. So what did you think about the Kwanzaa so far? What do you think?
I think it's the best thing in the whole entire city.
Oh, she thinks it's the best
in the whole city. In the whole city.
So what did you do for Kwanzaa? Did you participate?
I participated, listened, and be the best girl I could be.
Right,
excellent.
That's the principles of Kwanzaa. That's living Kwanzaa.
There it is.
There it is right there.
That's it. Oh, we are so proud of you.
And you said Kwanzaa's in our what?
Heart.
In our heart.
There we go. We got to live it in our hearts. And that's a real thing.
Look at us. We all going.
Job well done.
Yes. We can't say nothing else.
Say thank you.
Thank you.
All right. So but yeah. Dr. Jill, look. We are excited every time we come and
yes.
we prepare. We're like, you know what? We're going to Columbus for a few days, and
yeah.
we're going to celebrate Kwanzaa.
Yeah.
But we're going to also celebrate our health and wellness.
Absolutely, together.
Because we're going to move into the 2020
come on
paradigm.
Now. Yeah, the new decade.
The new decade, the new everything. And we're going to have the principles, but we're also going to think about our health and well-being.
Yeah, it's so necessary. As we go into the new decade, for many people,
mm-hmm.
it will be a time to set new goals
mm-hmm.
as they think about a new decade
mm-hmm.
for all of us. And we have to make sure that we lead the charge into the new decade
mm-hmm.
with health and wellness being a part of what everybody is thinking about doing.
Yes.
So I thank you for continuing to come and allowing us to continue to communicate that, not only here at the Kwanzaa event, but then just in our community and in our lives. It's so very necessary for the future of Black people to be healthy and well. Absolutely.
Yeah, so let's move on though. Let's move on
yeah.
to Dr. Linda Myers. I got a chance to talk with her last night.
Yeah.
She was wonderful.
Yes.
So what is your experience with her?
Be not for Dr. Myers.
Okay.
You know, Dr. Myers, I had the opportunity to receive my master's degree from the Ohio State University.
Yes.
And Dr. Myers was, of course, one of my instructors, and she was life-changing.
Okay.
It is because of her optimal worldview. that then I became even more awakened. My spirit was already seeking the greatness of African people, in which I am a member of the Black and African community here in Columbus and throughout the diaspora.
Okay.
But she then gave me knowledge and wisdom in that space to know our greatness and then to exercise my purpose in our greatness.
Yes.
She is one of our community's greatest contributions. And I even say beyond Ohio State University.
Yes.
For Black people in Columbus as well as throughout the country and I'm quite sure throughout the world.
Yes.
We are appreciative of Dr. Myers, which is why I said that she needed to be honored this year.
Yes, she was one of your honorees, wasn't she?
As well as Dr. Dotley tonight.
Okay.
Dr. Dotley in our community has raised generations of us here in Columbus. Me, my children. Now he has grandchildren and great-grandchildren in this community, both biologically and not biologically, in which he has then, from Dr. Myers' teaching at a scholarly level, gave us practical applications and opportunities to live this work so that we can know our success and our greatness. Absolutely.
Okay.
We have people in our community, not only in Columbus, in your community, in Ohio, and across the world, that are Black people, African Americans, that are doing work that we have to honor. We have to honor ourselves.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes. And so I want to ask, what are we doing tonight? I mean, tomorrow night. Yeah.
Oh, so tomorrow night going to continue to be hot? We're going to continue
to be hot. We're
going to keep health and wellness going.
Yes.
We have one of your favorites.
Yes.
Dr. Miss Latanya Settles is going to come in.
Yes.
And she's going to do Fit for Life.
Mm-hmm.
And she's going to keep us moving. Keep us moving this year. We also have another honoree from the business community.
Okay.
Sister Enya Njai.
Yes,
she is my insurance agent as well.
Yes.
And she is really about not only providing us insurance, but providing us education. So we honor her and the work, and she's been doing it for so long in such a great way. Tomorrow night, we also have some performances that you don't want to miss. So again, we just keep it going every night. We keep it with education.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, we're going to have a panel. Oh, yeah, I would be remiss.
Okay.
Tomorrow is Ujamaa, cooperative economics. So we're going to have a panel on cooperative economics.
Okay.
Tomorrow night, you don't want to miss. And then the last night, which is Monday night, we are now going to have another honoree from the arts community. Sister Fran with Roots Gallery, been in our community forever. A woman of greatness, and we just appreciate all she's done. And then we're going to have a community conversation. And folks need to be here for the community conversation because we're going to talk about how the principles are relevant in 2020 and how, as a community, we are going to apply them for our greatness going forward.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much.
And the Caramu.
Oh, we can. We got to eat.
So we're going to end on a grand caramel. So we are looking forward to finishing strong.
All right.
Yes.
And thank you so much, Dr. Gio, for sharing that.
I know.
And you too, and my dear.
I know. Say
are
goodbye.
You gonna say something?
Say bye.
Bye. And I love Kwanzaa so much.
All right.
All
she loves Kwanzaa
thank
much.
You. Yes.
Thank you. Habarigani, sis. That's Ujima today.
It's Ujima. Don't
it's
be Ujima. Put me on the
collective
spot.
Work
she
and responsibility.
Put me on the spot. You know what I mean? My focus is on health and wellness, but we're going to bring all that together.
All of it again.
And what does it mean?
Oh, today is Ujima collective. One of my favorite principles.
And why do you like it?
Oh, collective work and responsibility.
Okay,
Because as a community, what we have gotten away from is everybody participating in the process, feeling the need to participate in the process, and holding each other accountable for participating in the process.
Okay.
If we do that more, we will be even greater in the future.
All right, then.
All right, then.
That's done.
Done.
Wrap it up.
With a wrap. Bye. Love you, sis.